Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello my dear students, welcome to Second Commerce Business Studies online classes. In last class, we understood the concept of capital structure. What exactly capital structure? Capital structure is a mix between owner's fund and borrowed funds. In this class, we are going to discuss about the factors affecting the choice of capital structure. There we studied the concept of financial leverage, favorable financial leverage, unfavorable financial leverage, trading on equity and all. So when the cost of debt is lower than the return on investment, that situation is called as favorable financial leverage. When the cost of debt is higher than the return on investment, that situation is considered as unfavorable financial leverage. So a firm has to take a proper exact decision for the smooth running of business activities and all. It should decide about, should carefully take the decision about the proportion of debt and equity. We know that for one or another reason, firm need to acquire or borrow some other funds from outside the organization, and it should use that fund in effective manner, inefficiently, right? So deciding about the proportion of debt and equity comes under the concept, important factor under financial management. So the capital structure here, under the capital structure, the decision about the long term finance, the proportion of long term finance of to raise the capital is determined here. So the most favorable financial decision or most favorable proportion of debt and equity is considered as optimum capital structure. So selection of proportion of debt and equity is depends on its risk and cost and riskiness of concern of particular source, right? So we can say that before selecting the source of debt and equity or the selection of proportion, the firm has to analyze carefully about different factors, different situations. By a careful decision has to be taken by the management before selecting the source of finance. So a firm, if a company is planned to to maximize the shareholders' wealth, a firm has to take a corrective decision about the proportion of debt and equity. So firm, if a firm is planned to raise debt, or if it must have sufficient cash flows within the organization, any organization is having good cash flow, positive cash flow, then it can raise finance through debt financing. So some of the factors are affecting while selecting the optimum capital structure. Under that, the first one is cash flow position. Cash flow position of a company. Say, of course, while deciding the portion of debt financing, the capital, optimum capital structure, the firm has to analyze the future cash flow position of the project. Okay, future outflow of position of the particular project. Say if firm is opting the debt financing as a source of fund, then firm should have positive cash flow, because the firm has to pay regular interest and principal amount at a fixed given date, right? So at that time, firm should have positive cash flow. See, a company needs cash to meet different activities. Company require fund to meet different expenses or different activities of a business concern. For example, to meet its daily, normal business operation, firm need finance, firm need cash, or to meet the debt payment, interest payment, or any other investment in fixed asset. For that, firm need fund, okay, to invest in fixed asset, and also to meet debt servicing, to pay debt servicing activities, for example, payment of interest, payment of principal amount, or any other payment obligation. For that, business required cash. So based on, for all this, a business concern requires fund. Business firm requires finance to meet all these expenses. So based on the cash flow position of a firm, it can select the proportion of debt and equity. If firm select debt as of debt as a source of fund, then that should have, that firm should have positive cash flow position. If the cash flow position of the company is in stable or in a negative, then firm should not raise a fund through the debt financing. It is better to opt equity share. So if any firm is using debt financing as a source of fund, that firm should have good cash flow position, because regular payment of interest and repayment of principal amount is compulsory to such a organization. So for that reason, based on the cash flow position of the company, it should decide about the proportion of debt and equity. So that is the first factor which affect the choice of capital structure. Based on the cash flow position of the company, company should decide about the proportion of debt and equity. And next factor is interest coverage ratio. See, the interest coverage ratio means, it measures how many times a company can cover its interest payment. How easily, see, interest coverage ratio measures the company's ability how many times a company can pay its interest payments and all. Interest payments, that calculation is considered as, called as interest coverage ratio. It measures the company's ability, how easily it covers, how easily it pay the interest expenses, that is under interest, calculated under interest coverage ratio. So the ratio can be calculated by using by dividing the earnings per share, earnings before interest and tax of a company, by its total interest expenses, that is ICR, means interest coverage ratio, is equal to company's earning before interest and taxes, EBIT, divided by interest. So this formula is help to find out interest coverage ratio. Higher the interest coverage ratio means companies have good ability, good capacity to meet its interest, number of times can pay its interest amount, that when company is having high ICR, high interest coverage, high percentage of interest coverage ratio. So for example, a company is having company is earning 50,000, company's EBIT is 50,000, and it interest expenses approximately 25,000, then the ratio is 2. So if lower the interest coverage ratio, it results in firm is not able to pay its interest amounts during the financial period. So if the firm have good or high interest coverage ratio, then firm's position is in good condition, firm have good position to pay its interest amount and all. So based on the interest coverage ratio, firm can decide to select the proportion of debt and equity. Say for example, if the interest coverage is low, it means what? Firm is having greater chance of bankruptcy. Means firm is having greater financial risk. So it means low interest coverage ratio means there is high financial risk. So firm, based on the interest coverage ratio, firm can select the proportion of debt. If good interest coverage ratio is there, then firm can select debt financing to raise finance. And the next factor is debt service coverage ratio. This concept is also known as debt coverage ratio. It is the ratio of operating income. It is the ratio of operating income available to pay its expenses. Say, for example, it is a total ratio. It is a ratio of operating income available to pay its interest and principal amounts. Pay the debt servicing. Operating income is operating income available to the business concern to pay the debt servicing or to meet the debt servicing. That debt servicing includes payment of principal amount payments. Okay, so the debt service coverage ratio is also known as debt coverage ratio. It can be calculated by using this formula, DSCR equal to profit after tax plus depreciation plus interest plus non-cash expenses divided by preference dividend plus interest plus repayment obligations. Or we can use one more formula, that is net operating income divided by total interest expenses or total debt service. So in debt service coverage ratio means the ratio of operating income available to debt servicing. That debt servicing include payment of interest and payment of principal amount. So this debt service coverage ratio is a popular benchmark used to measure the entity's ability to meet its debt servicing. That debt coverage ratio can be calculated by using this formula, profit after tax plus depreciation plus interest plus non-cash expenses divided by preference dividend plus interest plus repayment obligations. Or we can use one more formula, that is net operating income divided by total debt service. Based on debt service coverage ratio, firm can decide to select the proportion of debt and equity. And the next factor affect the choice of capital structure is return on investment. Return on investment can be calculated by, see return on investment means what? It is the ratio between total investment or net profit and the cost of investment. It is a ratio between net income, net profit and the total cost of investment. This return on investment is used to measure the efficiency of investment. Say, to know about the efficiency of our of the business concerns investment, firm has to calculate, firm need to calculate its return on investment. So how we can calculate return on investment? Return on investment can be calculated by using this formula, EBIT divided by total investment. Total investment into 100. So firm's EBIT divided by its total investment into 100. So we know the concept of return on investment. How? See, in the capital structure, at time of while we studying the financial leverage, we studied the concept of return on investment also. Firm is having, when the firm is having high return on investment, that is, return on investment is greater than the cost of debt, then it is called as favorable financial leverage, right? So when the firm is having good return on investment, it positively influence to increase the earning per share of the company. So firm can use, at that time firm can use more cheaper debt sources to enhances the rate of earning per share, and at that time firm can use more financial debt. But we know that financial risk also increases at that time. But return on investment, based on the return on investment, company, a business concern should select the source of finance. Suppose company's return on investment is very less, so at that time cost of debt increases. When the when return on investment is less than the cost of debt, it surely increase the financial risk of a concern. At that time using debt financing is not advisable to the business concern. So based on the return on investment, firm should decide to select the source of finance. If good situation, if return on investment is in positive way or positive manner, high return on investment is there, then firm earning per share is also increased. Through that, firm can maximize the shareholders' wealth also. At that time, firm can use more debt to financing also. But if the cost of debt is higher than the return on investment, it is, at that time, the use of debt financing is not preferable to such business organization. So based on return on investment of a company, based on the return on investment of a particular project, company should select the proportion of debt. Okay, so the next one is cost of debt. Based on the cost of debt, say return on investment increases, it means what? Its capacity to it results in increasing the earning per share. So here cost of debt also, say firm should select the source of finance based on cost of debt. For example, the availability of debt is in cheaper, say for example cost of debt is cheaper than the return on investment, then firm can select, better to select debt financing as a source of finance to run the business activities. So based on the cost of debt, say we know that when firm is utilizing higher debt, it results in increasing financial risk also. So for example, favorable financial situation, firm can utilize more cheaper debt, because favorable financial leverage help the management to raise the debt financing at cheaper cost. At that time using debt financing is better to the business concern. But the cost of debt is high in some situation, at that time it is, the firm should not raise fund through debt financing. Based on the cost of debt, the rate of interest, in case the rate of interest on the debt is more, okay, then it is not preferable. Debt financing is not preferable to the business concern. Same way, if the rate of interest is lesser, then it is better to the business concern to select the debt financing as source of fund, a source of long-term finance. So based on the cost of debt, firm should decide to select the portion of debt in the overall capital and the tax rate. Next factor is tax rate. See, for interest which is calculated, say interest calculated on total debt amount is completely deductible expense from computation of tax. At that time, cost of debt is affected by the rate of tax rate. So tax rate is directly affect to the cost of debt. So based on the tax rate, before selecting the source of fund, firm should analyze the tax rate. After that only company can select the source of better proportion of debt financing in the overall capital. The next factor is cost of equity. So cost of equity means expectation of shareholders. So before selecting the capital structure, optimum capital structure, firm should analyze the factor of cost of equity also. So what exactly cost of equity? Cost of equity means here it refers to the expectation of shareholders from the company. Say for example, using of higher debt affect the cost of equity. How? When any firm, say for example, a firm is utilizing higher debt, then the expectation of shareholders also increases. Mainly because we know that use of higher debt increases the financial risk of a business also. Say by analyzing the different factors before selecting the source of fund, firm need to analyze different sources. After that, if a firm select debt to finance as a source, then higher usage of debt also increases the cost of equity. It means it also increases the expectation of shareholders of a company, from the company. Okay, it means say cost of equity, when the firm is utilizing higher debt, it also increases the cost risk of equity shareholders also. So say because we know that higher use of debt increases the financial risk also, that financial risk may adversely affect the wealth of the shareholders. So for that reason, therefore a company should use debt financing only to the limited level. Beyond that, say for example, even after the limited level, if the company is using debt capital, it directly affect the cost of equity. It continuously increasing the cost of equity, that if the that position is not good to the business organization. So cost of equity capital starts increasing rapidly when the company is utilizing higher debt financing. So it may adversely affect the shareholders market value of the share. So it is not a good situation, right? So based on the cost of equity, so only firm can utilize the debt financing only to the limited level. So cost of equity also affect the choice of capital structure. The next factor is affecting to the choice of capital structure is flotation cost. So flotation cost is a expense incurred while issuing the securities to the public. Okay, so it may include, say for example, when issuing equity share capital, preference share capital, debenture, at that time many costs incurred, okay, to the business concern, that expenses are called as flotation cost. It may include some commission of underwriters, brokerages or stationery expenses, etc. So cost of issuing equity, issuing securities more than cost of debt. So that's why many business concerns are interested to raise debt financing rather than equity financing. So because flotation costs are high in case of issuing securities, but the cost of debt of raising debt financing is less than the cost of issuing securities to the public. So that's why, based on the flotation cost, so when selecting the choice of capital structure, this flotation cost also affects to the choice of capital structure. So flotation cost is the cost incurring at the time of issuing securities. So these expenses may include underwriters' commissions or some stationery expenses or brokerage. For these expenses, we call those expenses as flotation cost. So high flotation cost may less attract to the business concern to raise finance. So many formalities has to pass be passed by the organization. So this leads to, say, debtor financing, issuing of debt, raising the debtor financing is cheaper than the issuing of equity shares or any other preference shares to the general public. So flotation cost also one of the factors which influence the choice of capital structure. And the next factor is risk consideration. As we know that higher the usage of debt financing increases the financial risk of a business concern, right? So based on the risk consideration or based on the risk of the source of finance, source of fund, firm can select select the proportion of debt and equity. If the firm is effort to bear high risk, then debt financing is a better source to raise a fund. If the firm is not want to take more risk, then it is better to opt any other source of finance to raise a fund. So firm has two types of risk. The one is operating risk, it is also called as business risk, and the next one is financial risk. Operating risk, say financial risk means what? Financial risk is, risk means firm's unable position or firm's inability to meet its expenses, meet its debt servicing, then its payment, it may be the interest payment of interest or principal payment, it is known as financial risk. So firm has to face two types of risk. One is operating risk, which is also called as business risk. It means firm's inability to meet its permanent operating cost. For example, payment of rent of buildings, okay, or a payment of wages and salaries. These are all the permanent operating expenses to the business concern. So firm's inability to meet these expenses is called as operating risk or business risk. And one more risk is what? Financial risk. Financial risk are the risk of company. It is a inability position or unable situation, inability to meet its fixed cost, permanent fixed cost. For example, payment of interest or payment of preference dividend, payment of other payment obligation, these are all comes under financial risk. So financial risk is a firm's inability to meet its permanent fixed cost. So both these types of risk affects the choice of capital structure. Based on these, business risk include both these types of risk. Based on that, based on the risk level, say risk level of the source of fund, firm can select the, say for example here, debt financing higher usage or debt financing has high risk than the equity financing. So based on the risk consideration, riskiness of the particular source of finance or fund, firm can select the portion, proportion of debt and equity. And the next one is flexibility. In this, according to this principle, flexibility, say capital structure should be fairly flexible. It means what? Flexibility means if need be, okay. Say firm's capital can be easily decreased or increased according to the situation. So to maintain the power of flexibility, or to maintain this flexibility, a firm has to maintain some borrowing power. Some borrowing power, that borrowing power is useful to which can be used in unforeseen, to solve some unforeseen future. So that's why firm's capital should be fairly, if need be, if the firm is needful in that cases, in that situation, firm's capital can be increased or decreased easily. That is called as flexibility. For when preparing the capital structure of company, it should be fairly flexible. Okay. So after that, the one more factor is affected to the capital structure is control. Say equity shareholders have all authority to participate in activities of different activities of the business, right? So capital structure, decision about the proportion of capital structure is affect the control power of equity shareholders. How? Say for example, if the firm is raising equity financing, raising the funds through equity shares, at that time number of shareholders are increased, right? So when we are issuing high equity shares to the general public, at that time number of equity shareholders also increased. So at that time, that number of the power of the, or the control of overall activity is also distributed among the number of shareholders. At that time, it adversely affect to the, it does not entertain, it does not entertain the existing shareholders of the company. So at that, when selecting the proportion, or when deciding the proportion of debt and equity, or the equity financing, firm need to focus on the interest of present or existing equity shareholders. Whereas on the other hand, issuing of debentures or raising finance through debt financing, the control does not affect to any debenture holder, because debenture holders don't have any authority or control over the activities of the management. Only equity shareholders have the voting power, right to vote, or they have ownership power. Okay, so debenture holders don't have any authority, don't have any control over the activities of the management. So when selecting the source of, or the proportion of, deciding the proportion of debt and equity, firm should focus on the interest of existing equity shareholder. It should not curb the power or the control of existing shareholder. It should entertain, they should take care of the interest of equity, present existing shareholders also. Then regulatory framework, because every company has to be has to follow some regulatory framework which is framed by law. So say for example, issuing of equity shares or debentures made under the regulations of SEBI, right? So many regulatory frameworks has to have to be followed by the organization in order to maintain some uniformity among different industries, and some ideal proportion is ideal proportion, such as ideal proportion of debt and equity, that such as 2:1, 4:1, 6:1 is distributed to different types of industries by the law itself. So organization should follow the instructions which is given by the law. So organization, when selecting the capital structure or deciding the proportion of debt and equity, organization has to need to follow some regulatory framework to maintain uniformity. So stock market condition, next factor is stock market condition. What is stock market condition? Stock market condition is nothing but the increased or decreased trend in the capital, in the stock market. Say for example, when stock market is in positive moment or stock market is in good situation, good condition, many investors are interested to invest in share capital because stock market is in increased condition, better positive condition. At that time, many investors are interested to invest in share, in shares and all. So on the other hand, if the stock market condition is very dull, at that time many investors are afraid to invest in share capital. So same way, if the market condition is in cheerful, at that time what will happen? Many investors are ready to invest in share capital. So at that time, debt financing, financing through equity equity is better to such organization. Or else if the stock market condition is in is dull, at that time debt financing is the best source to raise the fund. So based on the stock market condition, so before selecting the source of finance, before selecting the proportion of debt and equity, firm should care, should analyze the stock market condition. Okay, so that is about stock market condition. So capital structure of other companies also affect the choice of firm's present capital structure. Say proportion of debt and equity. Say many companies are following, preparing capital structure based on industrial norms. Many companies are preparing the capital structure by following the industrial norms. When we are following one particular company's capital structure, we should not blindly follow the industrial norms of other companies' industrial norms or other companies' capital structure. For example, we can say that what firm's positions, or else if a firm cannot afford to face high risk, then it should not raise finance through debt financing, because only other companies are raising debt financing. So we can also raise debt financing even we are not afford to face high risk. That is not a good decision by the management. So based on the ability, based on the capacity, only we can select the debt financing or any other source of finance. So capital structure of other companies also affect the choice of capital structure. So based on the capital structure of a company, so this decision about the proportion of debt and equity, proportion of source of finance, is very important to the business concern to meet its expenses or to run the business activities. So before selecting the proportion of debt and equity, firm has to, or before selecting the mix between debt and borrowed fund and owner's fund, firm should analyze carefully about these factors. After that, only firm can select the best proportion of debt and equity. So these factors will help the management to take good decision, to take correct decision about the proportion of debt and equity. Thank you for watching this video.